巴黎奥运会来了，外网上一些外国运动员测试他们环保床的视频火了。
Hearing about the cardboard beds in the village, I'm going to show you what they look like. This is cardboard. As you can see, it's like a box. Then you've got the mattress, and then these cardboard boxes here, like so, with the mattress on top and a mattress topper. And then we get our own little Harris 24. And as you can see, they're pretty sturdy.
Let me show you more about the cardboard beds. So that's an extended bed. I obviously didn't get an extended bed because I'm sure.
The cupboard's changed.
Oh.
This says extra firm. And like, this is moderate. So if you don't feel comfortable, you can flip it.
So we're here in Paris to test out the beds with various activities. Let's go.
I'm at the Paris Olympic Games. Nope, they passed the test.
Structure of this bed will collapse. There's more than one person on it. So what?
Not everyone finding the sleeping conditions funny.
It's actually rock solid.
Suni Lee responding, OMG, I might cry.
我发现澳洲运动员啊，还是比较积极的分享了自己在巴黎的体验的，比如这些自行车运动员们。
So our van got broken into last night. Luckily my bikes weren't in there. Although my bike bags were in there with some things in it. Crazy start to the trip. Right, thank God for bag tags. We found our bags. All our
stuff. Massage table!
No way.
Oh my God. Jesus. Oh, look at all your tools on the ground. Your gloves.
Oh, boy.
They ate your chockies. Oh. Make sure you sanitize that thing. I don't want to lay on that later.
Where's the other one? Bro,
这不可能吧？明明外网上还有外国游客是夸赞他们的呀。
This is such a beautiful bakery. It smells so good, and the food looks amazing.
What is it?
Yeah, just a cool coffee shop. It's just really good coffee. It's really hot. I need an iced coffee right now.
Check it out. A little tiny hole in the wall. So you should know that. The two kind of hip spots for Parisians, where the actual locals would come.
I was just about to have my life changed by a man that loves sandwiches even more than I do.
J'ai entendu que tu fais les meilleurs sandwichs dans tout Paris.
Non, de ta vie.
Ah, de
the best sandwich in your life.
Okay, I guess we gotta try it. Alain says the best sandwich of my life. Let's see if I'm actually gonna join the Miam Miam Club. This is pretty much one of the better sandwiches I've ever had. Is it the best I've ever had? I'm not sure, but it's definitely outstanding. The cheese has like oiled its way through the bread, through all the ingredients, everything's like become one. Look, the sandwiches are great. How to get free water in any restaurant. This right here is a carafe d'eau, and it basically just means I love the service water. The tap water. I don't know about you, but free tastes better than a fine wine. That's amazing. We probably found a good bakery.
We didn't find a good bakery. Ruby found us the best croissants in Paris, as rated by some local food critics, and they were not lying. Maison d'Isabelle for the win.
So it turns out they actually won the best croissant award of all of Paris in 2018. I don't know what's been going on these last 6 years, but in my eyes, they're still winners. Add this one to your list.
但你说在那边吃的特别好，可是这些澳洲女运动员们却分享了自己的运动餐是这个样子的。
Dinner tonight, salad bowl with some pastrami. What are you having?
Pasta with ham and some salad.
Nice. And here comes the ribs. What are you gonna eat?
No protein.
She needs to get some protein on her plate. It's most important. But Ruby has a lot of allergies. Anyway, we're eating dinner at 10:30 p.m. tonight because we only just got back from training. What are you eating tonight?
Some eggs and some cheese.
Nice.
And some little bread.
Cute. And Brie? Nice, yummy. That looks good.
据说巴黎还很热心地给运动员们提供了车，把他们送到需要去的地点。只不过车门啊，还需要运动员们手动地关一下。
I lost it.
ワタさん、ドアが閉まらないよ。どうしよう。
僕たちは練習できないみたいです。
絶対に練習はし。
那这些呢，我也不知道说什么好。巴黎到底是一个什么样的地方呢？明明有外国博主们是这么介绍的呀。
The majestic city of Paris is over 2,000 years old, and its form has changed radically throughout the centuries. Before the Romans conquered her, the city was limited to a small settlement in this small island in the middle of the river Seine, later named Île de la Cité.The island of the city.
First of all, you're going to want to check out a sunrise. And if you're not an early morning person, hey, make it a sunset. But be prepared for crowds. Famous attractions basically built up right on this river. And if you're going to do it by foot, be prepared for a lot of walking. But if you want to spare your feet and have way more fun, Paris travel hack number one. You got to rent one of these Lime scooters. Way cheaper than a taxi, just as fast, and way cooler. Our two friends who have been living here in Paris hadn't even tried them till today.
Alors, the building itself is actually an old train station. The details of the building are just as much part of the art here. It's so beautiful in here. Now, one thing I will add about these scooters is that while they're incredibly amazing, fun, and practical to get around the city, you can't just leave them like this. Right now, they're actually unparked, and someone could literally jump on it and roll off. Little champagne glasses and a couple bottles of wine. We were planning to basically hang out in this grassy area, but with the Olympics coming, they've actually barred it off.But that's okay. We're going to go find a little spot somewhere and enjoy the beautiful sunset and the end of a perfect crazy day in Paris. Plan B, what is it, Allison?
Plan B is actually Plan A.
Plan A?
Yeah.
I like that.
Way better.
That's a way better attitude than mine.
We're going to sit and look at the Eiffel Tower from afar. So it's actually better because you get a view of it, you get the
water. Tell me. This is a secret gem.
No one else thought about it beside us.
That's beautiful.
We found a good spot.
The sunset over the Eiffel Tower was so stunning.
可据说咱们的运动员也说了，九个运动员奥运村里边同住一屋，仅两个厕所，还说那里的房间呢是没有空调的。另外马上就要开幕式了，却有人说呀，完整的彩排都没有进行过。就算在这个信息爆炸的时代，我也不敢相信已经有这么多令人目瞪口呆的信息呀，毕竟那可是奥运会呀。后来呢，我的心情稍微的平复了一点，是因为看到了巴黎奥运的中国元素，还不是个简单的中国元素啊，是有外国记者呢在巴黎竟然背着当年北京2008年奥运会的背包，他这样说
：The bag is part of the history. I use the bag from the year 2008.
Do you like Beijing?
Hi, very much.
我真的不敢想啊，这一晃啊已经16年了。再看视频的各位，16年前的你在做什么呢？我记得那个时候真的很激动，好骄傲啊。现在家里边还留着一套福娃呢。北京欢迎你那首歌呢，到现在我偶尔还会听还会唱。说实话，总感觉那个时候的奥运会呢，国际关注度更高。我们举办的是奥运会，也是妥妥的提升了咱们在国际上的声誉，也让我们增强了民族自豪感。其实吧，就现在啊，虽然呢我们看看巴黎奥运的热闹，偶尔开开玩笑啥的，倒也不是一个完全要唱衰的心态。开幕式呢我会看一眼，比赛呢也会去关注。最重要的是啊，衷心祝愿咱们中国的健儿们能够取得好成绩，同时平安顺利地完成所有的比赛，不要有什么不愉快的经历才好，期待着他们凯旋归来。